local preference. In this video, we'll see how to implement and verify the local preference values. So before we implement and verify the local preference, let us quickly revise what we have learned in our previous videos. We have seen local preference is a BGP attribute, which is a well-known and discretionary attribute, which is going to define how you should exit the autonomous system member. And by default, highest value is preferred, and the default local preference value will be 100, and it is going to be advertised for all the internal BGP neighbors. Now, we also discussed that it is going to affect all the routers within the same autonomous system member. Like one example here, let's say this is my destination network which I want to reach here. So I got my local AS, this is my AS, and in this AS I got two exit paths. One exit path is going via router A, and we got another exit path going via router B. Now in this, my requirement will be, I want to ensure that all the routers inside my AS. Now all the routers in my AS, whatever the AS is 64520, which means if you have as many routers, whatever the router, whatever the size of the network. Now all the routers, we need to ensure that it should prefer via this route. Now what we can do is we can apply some local preference value, something higher than what is default here. The default it will be 100, or you can apply something called 150 also. So it all depends upon what you apply. Or even we can say that to reach, let's say if you have multiple networks, I got 11 dot network and I got 12 dot network. Now even using route maps, just like we did this with weight in our previous videos, I can match 11 dot network and I can set the local preference of 200 for this network so that it prefers via this route. And I can match this network and I can set the local preference value of 200 for this 12 dot network. So even we can do something like this path manipulations, where we can differentiate and we can define some of the traffic, or for traffic for some specific routes should exit via router A, and traffic for some other networks should exit via B. So let's try to implement and verify in our lab here. So I'm going to use the same diagram which we have been using in our previous videos. If you try to see here, we got all the four routers, the same diagram which we have used in your weight lab also. And this router 1 is in the AS 500, router 2, router 3 in the AS 600, and router 4 is in the AS 700. And the first step will be configuring the IBGP and BBGP configurations. Like in case if you are going to continue with your previous lab, let's say if you remember the previous lab, what we did is we have applied weight attribute in our previous labs. If you are going to continue with the previous lab, then the first thing we need to do is we need to remove that weight. So we need to ensure that whatever the networks advertised, like apart from this, we also have this 12 dot network here, which is also advertised in my initial configurations. I'm going to remove the weight, whatever I have applied in my previous lab. Or if you are going to start this lab from the beginning and you don't have any of the BGP configurations, then the first step will be you have to configure the basic IBGP and EBGP, like the same way we did in our previous labs, as per the diagram, and then verify the neighborship and ensure that it uses the default path selection process without any attributes applied, and then finally changing the next hop. So if you remember, we have changed the next hop on router 2 pointing to router 3, and then on the router 3 pointing to router 2. So these are all the same configurations. I already have them in my notepad, so I'll quickly copy paste these configurations here, like the same configurations as per my diagram. So you are good with this configuration by this time. So I'll just simply go and configure all these configurations. Like this is something what we did in our previous lab. So I'm not going to use weight. And then you can just simply say no access list 12 if you're going to continue with your previous lab configurations. As of now, I'm not continuing with the previous lab configurations. So I'll simply go and remove all the things, and I will just copy paste the configs as per my diagram. Now on the router 1, advertising the 3 networks and then 2 neighbor commands as per the diagram. So I'll copy paste these configurations on my router 1. Here you can see on my router 1, I don't have any BGP running and I don't have any protocol running here. So I'm going to do the configuration from the basic with the basic IBGP and eBGP configurations. And the same thing on the router 2 also. On the router 2, I'm going to change the next hop address and then two neighbor commands, advertising the networks and also advertising the loopback interfaces. On the router 2, as per my documentation in my lab manual, I'm using 12.network also, which is the continuation of our previous lab. So I'm going to stick to the same advertisements. The same thing I'm going to do on the router 3 as well. And on the router 4. Now these are the basic configurations we are doing. And then we'll try to verify our IBGP and eBGP neighborship. So I'll start from the router 1. On the router 1, I should see two neighbors. Show IP BGP summary. One of the neighbor is up. The second will be up if our configurations are perfect. So you can see the neighborship is up. And similar way, I'll go and check on the router 3. Show IP BGP summary. The neighborship is up. Now once the neighborship is up, you should be able to see some of the routes coming from all the networks. So it's taking time for converging. So let us give some time for converging the networks. So meantime, we'll discuss our task here. Okay, so what I did, I just removed the neighbor or whatever the weight applied in my previous lab, in case if you're going to continue the same what we did in our previous video. So, or you can just do all the basic configurations the same way which I documented, and the same configurations what we did in our weight lab also. And after that, when you verify, the neighborship should come up, and then we have changed the next hop. This is also we did just now. Now our task is something like this. So now in this lab, we are going to verify how the local preference is going to work. Now in that, I'm going to take a simple scenario here where all the routers from AS 600 going to 700, by default it's going to prefer router 3. So if I try to verify my diagram here, so now to verify local preference, I'm going to use an autonomous system number which is having at least two routers, because we learned that when you apply local preference, it's going to affect all the routers inside the AS. So for testing purpose, we need to have at least two routers in our AS. If you have more than two, it will be good enough. So anyway, two is also okay. So as per this lab, what I want is now from AS 600 to reach AS 700. Okay, from 600 means we are going to start from here. The router 2, or we can say simply this 40.network. I'm going to consider this 40.network. Or you can take 10.network, it's up to you, any network you can check. So I'm going to consider this 40.network is getting advertised into AS 600 via this route and also getting advertised via this route. Now the router 2 is going to receive 40.network from this side with AS hops will be, it's coming from 700, that is your router 4, and then going to 500 and finally reaching to my autonomous system number. So the network is 40.network. Now the same 40.network is getting advertised from this side. So we are going to receive from this side the same 40.network, and I'm receiving with only one AS, that is 700 and I means this network origin code. This network is originated through BGP network command. Not of these two. Now when router 2 or router 3, so if you take any one of the router, in my example, if I take any one of the router, router 2 or router 3, so it's going to prefer which route. So by default, this route will be considered as the best route to reach 40.network. Why? Because the reason is it is having less number of AS path when we compare with the alternate route. So what exactly we want is, that's what the first point here says, all the routers, all the routes going from AS 600 and reaching the 700. So in my example, I'm going to consider as 40.network, which is belonging to AS 700. So by default, it all prefers exit via router 3, means this is our exit router, and which means router 3 is our preferred best route, preferred exit path. So that is the default exit path, we can say. Now our task is, now in this task we are going to apply the local preference, and my requirement is make sure that router 2 and router 3, that is all the routers in our AS600, everyone should go via router 2, router 4 using the local preference, which means I want to manipulate our routers, I want to change the local preference such that exit should be preferred over. So I want to change, this should be the best route. Okay, this is our best route, means AS600, all the routers in the AS600 should prefer this route and it should not go via this route. Now in this case, if you see here, in the previous lab we applied wait, but wait will not apply in this scenario, because if you apply wait, only this local router will have an impact to the routes. But if you want to impact all the routers inside the AS, then we need to apply local preference value. Now in our scenario, the default local preference value on this side is 100 and this side is also 100, so the default will be the same local preference value. So we want to prefer this exit path. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply the local preference value something more than 100. Let's say we are going to apply 200 on router 2, because router 2 is our exit path, this is preferred exit path. So you need to figure out which is your preferred exit router, and you have to go to that router. So this is our preferred exit router, so I have to go to this router and I have to change the local preference value on router 2 to something higher than 100. So I'm going to apply as 200. So that is what we need to do. Now if you verify the same thing in BGP outputs as well, on the router 2, by default 40.0 network is coming from both sides and the default path is this because of less AS hops. And even if you want, you can verify the routing table and you can try trace also. So in order to ensure that all the routes should prefer via exit 100, so in this case we need to change the local preference value of the router to higher than the default. That's what we are going to do. And to apply the local preference, we need to simply go to router mode and then we need to say simply BGP default local preference and something more than 100. So in my example, I'm going to use 400 here, so it can be 400, 200, it doesn't make difference. So let me just go with 400, exactly the same value which I'm using in my workbook. So I'll go to my router 2, which is my preferred exit path. I'm going to say router BGP 600, and before you apply, if you just want to verify how it is going, show IP BGP, you can say, or you can try trace to 40.1.1.1. It's going via 2.2.2.2, that is router 3 and then router 4. So we want to ensure that we should go via alternate route. So for that, I'm going to router 2 and simply say, even if you want, you can check on the router 3 also. So I'll show on the router 3 as well. If I use show IP BGP to reach 40.0 network, it's preferring via 3.3.3.2, which is direct router 4. Now in our scenario, once we apply the local preference on the router 2, now router 2 should go via router 1 and also router 3 also should go via this route. So that is our final requirement. So simply go to the border router. We need to say router BGP 600 and then the local preference will be applied by using this command. So BGP default local preference, and we can apply whatever the number I want. I can simply do this, and then whenever you manipulate any changes, it's recommended to clear the BGP process. Now once I clear the BGP and apply this, and if I verify show IP BGP summary, I can see 40.0 network is going via 1.1.1.1, and if I verify my routing table, to reach 40.0 network it's preferring via 1.1.1.1, that is router 1. And if I try to trace 40.1.1.1, you can see it's going via router 1 and then reaching the AS, and then reaching 4.4.4.1. Now similar way, if I check the same thing on the router 3 as well. Now if you try to see here, now from the router 2, now all the routes receiving from router 2 here, now router 2 is going via this route, and when router 3, that's what we learned. If you remember, the local preference value will be advertised to all the routers, all the IBGP peers, nothing but it is going to be advertised with all the routers to its internal BGP neighbors, which means when you apply the local preference of 400 on router 4, it's going to advertise to its internal router. You can see here. So now whatever the routes learned from router 2 will be applied a local preference value of 400 automatically, because here we did not match any routes. So we did not use any match statements or route maps to match. So we are not going to match anything, any routes, which means it's going to apply for all the routes. All the routes from router 2 will be automatically applied local preference value of 400. Now you can ask me why we are not able to see local preference value on the router 2 here, because now these routes here, the routes which are installed here, so these routes are coming from your external BGP neighbor, and anything towards the external BGP neighbor, you will not see the local preference value mentioned here. So it will be only mentioned for all your internal BGP peers. You can see here. So it's only for your internal BGP peers, not for external BGP peers. So now if I check on the router 3 as well to verify my routing table to reach 40 dot network, not only 40, you can see for to reach every network, it's going via 2.2.1, all the networks, because we did not match any network here. So if I try to trace, you can see it's going via 2.2.2.1, which is my router 2, and then goes to router 1, and then finally reaches my router 4. So all the AS. Now not only two routers, even if you have more than two routers, let's say in this AS you have two more routers. Now all the routers, every router inside your AS is going to prefer this route. So that is a major difference between the weight and the local preference. So when you apply weight, the weight will be applied only local to the router, whereas local preference will be advertised to all the routers inside the AS. Now this way, with this simple basic lab, we can verify how your local preference is going to work, and then you can possibly verify with show IP BGP commands, and even you can use this command like show IP BGP, or you can simply say show IP BGP specific network like 40.network. When you define like this, here also you can see what local preference value is applied, and it is considered as your best route, and the reason is it is having higher local preference than whatever the route coming from the other end.